Obeying the Gospel, May 8th, the Spacious Firmament on High. The heavens declare the glory of God, and the sky above proclaims His handiwork. Day to day pours out speech, and night to night reveals knowledge. There is no speech, nor are there words, whose voice is not heard. Their voice goes out through all the earth, and their words to the end of the world. Psalm 19, 1-4. The heavens declare the glory of God. So said David, a man who would have pondered the sky on many occasions, especially in the days of his youth as a shepherd. Every part of the world is full of wonder, obviously, but there is something special about the sky. We need to admire it more and think more deeply about why it is that the sky moves our hearts as it does. The heavens do not just declare the existence of God, although that is a point of immense importance in itself. It is His glory that is proclaimed. The word glory literally means brightness or splendor, but I want to propose an idea. When we are speaking of God, might we not think of glory as the joining of beauty and power? I think so. And I suspect that the blending of these two is why God's creation has such an impact on us. There are those who are not much moved by beauty. For them, power is of more interest. And then there are those for whom beauty has more appeal than power. But whoever you are, I predict that in the presence of something equally beautiful and powerful, your heart would melt. If you don't shut it down, your heart will tell you the truth. The heavens declare the glory of God. God is real. I used to doubt it, but I doubt it no more. Even though for me the days of trouble have come, Ecclesiastes 12:1 in the NIV, my heart has been ravished with beauty and power. The beauty is too powerful, and the power too beautiful to resist. The truth is not only true, it is a glorious, magnificent reality. And when I shall have been mended and made whole by the God who became man, I will thrill to the joy of being a part of His rescued people forever. As Joseph Addison beautifully wrote, "The spacious firmament on high, with all the blue ethereal sky and spangled heavens a shining frame, their great original proclaim. The unwearied sun from day to day does His Creator's power display, and publishes to every land the work of an almighty hand."